Let's take a look at creating a bill of materials for this assembly on a drawing. Let's start off by creating a new drawing, and I'm not going to change the name, and I'm not going to use a default template. I'm just going to start off using a drawing format, and let's use the master rep. It has a problem finding a component. Let's use sheet 1. And I'm just going to hit enter for all the other parameters that the format is looking for that aren't in the model. All right, so I've got my drawing started. Let's place an exploded view on here. So I will right click and choose general view. And I happen to know that there is a combined state that is exactly what I want. And oops. Left click to place it on the drawing. For this one, normally I like to display my components no hidden, but I'm going to show this one shading with edges. And for the scale, let's try, I want a bit of a bigger scale. Let's try 0.5 too big. A little too big. Let's go. Great, okay. So this will be sheet 1. Let's reposition this over here. And I will add another sheet by right-clicking on the sheet name and choosing new sheet. And this is where we will start off creating the table. I will go to the table tab. And for this table, let's start off. I just need 3 rows, and I'll show you why later on. And I'm going to do this one with 7 columns, and let's place it in the upper left-hand corner. All right, let's take the table, and I am going to fill in my header row. I'm gonna put a pause in the video here, and when I come back, you'll see that the header row is done. Just don't wanna bore you with that. All right, so I have my header row filled out. I resized some of the columns. I set some of the justification to center. Just some basic table functionality. Now to get Creo Parametric to extract the information from my assembly and place it in the table, I'm going to create what's called a repeat region. And when I click on that, we get the menu manager, and I'm going to add a repeat region. A simple repeat region is used for things like bills of material and cable harness, run tables. The 2D is used for documenting family tables. First, I will click in this cell over here and then this cell over there. And in the message area, it tells me that the region has been successfully created. So I can close the menu manager. Now, when I double click in a cell, I get the ability to place a report symbol in there. And so in the first column, I want Creo Parametric to assign an index number to the different components. So I will choose RPT, that's short for report, and then index. And in the second one over here, I'm going to extract the assembly member's name. And then the name is actually the common name. So this is assembly member, and then PTC common name. For the quantity, that's going to be RPT QTY. And then the weight, that's going to be assembly member. And the mass parameter isn't in here, so I can use user defined. And the symbol for that is pro_MP mass. I did another video on mass properties. And then the total weight, I'm going to come back to this in a moment. The last one that we're going to fill in for now is the assembly member. And then we have PTC material. And here are all the different material properties, but I just want the component's material name. So that is good. And now when I choose to switch symbols, couple times where I could update table, you can see that here we have the table filled out. So we can see that we have some materials in here. We have index, we've got the components number, the name, and so forth. But there are a few things that are wrong right now. First off, there are no quantities in here, and that's because I need to change the table's attributes. So I will go to repeat region and then attributes, and it prompts me in the lower left-hand corner to select a repeat region. And first off, I'm going to say that I want this to be recursive as opposed to flat. Flat means that it's just reporting the top level of the assembly, but recursive will allow it to go into all the different subassemblies. And in order to get the quantities filled out, you need to choose either no duplicates or no duplicates per level. I just want no duplicates. I just want basically a flat list of all the different parts that I need. So let's click done return. And so the table updated, and you can see that we have the quantities in here as well. And right now it's reporting individual parts and subassemblies as well. I don't want subassemblies in here, and that the subassemblies probably account for some of the weights showing up as zero. So to get rid of the subassemblies out of my bill of materials, I'm going to add a filter. So I can choose filters. Oh yeah, and actually just to prove that this is actually going to be filtered down, we can see right now there's a total of 89 lines in the table. So for filters, it's prompting me to select a region, and I'm going to do it by rule. If you do it by item, you can pick individual objects that you don't want listed in here. I'm going to add a filter, and the filter is going to start off with the name of the parameter with an ampersand. And I want the assembly member type. I could do either equal to part or not equal to assembly. And hit enter. I only want one filter, so I'll hit enter again. Then I'll click done and done return and done. And you'll notice that the number went from 89 down to 82. So there are 7 different subassemblies inside of here. All right, scrolling back up. Interesting, one of the components doesn't have a material signed. So for the total weight, I'm going to create a relation inside of this table. And to do that, again, we will go to repeat region. And in here we have relations. Prompts me to select a region. And here in the relation editor, we're going to create a new parameter and then assign it some expression to calculate it. So I'm going to say that I'm going to create a parameter called total weight, and that is going to be equal to the assembly member's pro MP mass. Now normally you would write that asm.mbr.proMPMass, and then multiply that times the report quantity, RPT.QTY. But there's a little trick, I don't know why it is that way, but in order to get the relations in a repeat region to work, you can't use the dots. Instead of using dots, you use an underscore. So for example, if I click on the verify button right now, it's gonna say, hey, you have got an error. So let's click OK to continue editing. If I take those dots and replace them with underscores, now when I click on verify, hey, no problem. So just remember, when you're writing relations in a repeat region, no dots, you're using underscores. I'll click OK and then done. And now in this cell, I'm going to double click and we're going to put a report relation user defined, and I remember, let's see, I called it what, total weight. And let's hit switch symbols a couple times, and there you can see that, hey, we have, you know, 0.027 times 2 equals 0.054. And some of these are really, really low numbers. And I actually want to change the number of decimal points in the weight and the total weight. So to do that, I can click on the cell and go to properties. And here it's saying that it's reporting the assembly member pro MP mass in there. If you do open bracket dot and then the number of decimal places, close bracket, that'll change the number of places, and you can see it updated there. clicking that cell and in the mini toolbar, again, go to the properties icon, bracket dot four, bracket on the end, it'll go to four decimal places. Okay, that looks good. Let's go down to the bottom of the table. The reason that I had an empty line is that I want to sum up the entire weight of this assembly. So again, we'll go to repeat region, and this time we're going to do a summation. And now it's prompting me to select a region. And now I'm going to click add, add one in there, and somewhat select a report symbol for summation. Let's go to the top one over here for total weight. And for the parameter name, I'm going to just call this ASSY weight. And now it's prompting me to select the table cell where I want it reported. And I click in this cell over here. Hey, it's saying all zeros, but it tells me there that I need to update the table in order to see the summation. Let's click update tables. Now I can see that my assembly weighs about 14 pounds. All right, so that is good so far. And you can see that my table is running off the length of the sheet. So let's click on the table. Oops, didn't select it. Let's get out of the menu manager, click on the table, and then from table over here, we can choose paginate. And now it's asking me to select, locate the extent of the table. Let's click about over there. And for now, I'm just gonna click the done button. And you'll notice that I automatically got a couple more sheets. So on sheet three is the continuation of the table. Sheet four, looks like I just got one line on sheet four. Oh well, normally I would blow that away, get rid of the extents and then change it so that I don't have an extra sheet on there. But for the sake of this video, I am not going to do that. And when I go to sheet three, you can see that it's just continuing on over there. Let's select the table. And if I go back to the paginate command, we can add a title. And it tells me select the repeat region and select the first row to define the header. And then the second row, I'm just gonna pick the same one as before. Now I click done. If I hop over to sheet two, let's go to the review tab and update tables. Now you can see that, hey, I've got the header on sheet two and sheet three as well. So that looks pretty good on there. The last thing that I'm going to do in this video is throw in a few different BOM balloons. And actually, before I do the balloons, I want to specify what kind of balloon I want to use in this table. So to do that, let me go back to the table tab, select the table, and then go to the properties button. Oops, I got the properties of the cell. Let's select table properties. There we go. Instead of the cells properties, I want the properties of the entire table. In the table properties dialog box, here we have BOM balloons. And for this repeat region, right now it's going to use a simple circle with the report index. You can use this drop-down list to say that you want to do a quantity split circle. So it'll put the report index in the top half of the circle and the quantity in the bottom part of the circle. If you want to use a different parameter, like say the component's number, the component's name, you could choose select change and use that to fill in the name of the report parameter. So that's good. Let's click the OK button and hop over to sheet one. And rather than just throw all the different balloons on here, which would clutter things up, let's just apply it to a bunch of different components. So I will choose to create balloons by component. And let's select, there we go. Holding down the control key, and I'm just picking a bunch of different components. Let me zoom in over here. And let's actually select want to get this bolt over here just to show one that has a quantity in it. Oops, stop zooming. Okay, that's good enough. Click the OK button, and there we can see that we have some bomb balloons on here. They're automatically spaced out. And you can see, so for find number 17, it's got a quantity of 8. The other ones I picked just have a quantity of 1. If you wanted to, you could use the filter in the lower right-hand corner and swipe a box over the different bomb balloons, and then right-click and choose cleanup bomb balloons. You get a nice little dialog box that allow you to control the offset from the geometry. Also, you can generate the snap lines for dragging the balloons around, and also if you need to stagger balloons, the distance between them. But let's not do that. Let's jump over to the repeat region. And so there's a lot more functionality inside of here that we will cover in the next video, including things like fixing the index and sorting the regions by different columns. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and click the subscribe button. Thank you very much.